I read about quantum physics, and at one point I not only wanted to understand it deeper, I wanted to actively contribute to the research.
So quantum mechanics is a very successful theory to describe things at very small scales, for example atoms and electrons, but we don't experience it in our day-to-day life, so in our macroscopic world. What we're interested in is, from an experimental perspective, trying to understand why this is. I find this really fascinating because although it's a very successful theory and it has applicability in technology, there are still these very fundamental open questions.
So the basic question we try to address here is why quantum theory is as it is. The standard textbook approach puts in the front mathematical formulation and axioms, rather some abstract concepts that are hard to connect to the real world. We are trying to reverse this logic and to put the physics in the front, and from which we try to derive necessary mathematics to explain quantum phenomena. So in this way, quantum mechanics is not anymore a theory about particles and waves, it's rather a theory about possibilities and limitations of information processing.
So I'm an experimental physicist, and there can be many theories out there to describe certain phenomena, but unless we observe it in the lab, we don't really know whether this theory is true or not. So the main thing that drives us in this research is curiosity, meaning that we're trying to understand the world around us. But because we're doing experiments really at the cutting edge, there are often technological kind of byproducts from our research with potential applications.
Why is foundational research important? So the answer is twofold. On one hand side is pushing the boundaries of human knowledge. That's why it does not require justification. But you can take also pragmatic answer to the question. This is the lesson from history. What is basic science of today is future technology.
I decided to work in the research group of Philipp Walther in the University of Vienna because I was listening to a talk of one of his PhD students in the summer school, and I found the topic quite interesting and fascinating.
Even before joining the group of Markus Aspelmeyer at the University of Vienna, I was very interested in his work, and we really had shared research interests regarding experimentally testing the foundations of quantum mechanics, and for me it was a very natural choice to join his efforts.
We have an amazing synergy and interaction between research groups here at the University of Vienna, and essentially every piece of theory that we develop here is verified by our colleagues in the lab next door. I believe this is a unique opportunity for a theorist.
The question I ask myself is, up to which point can we understand the part of nature that we're not even able to imagine?